Hi, my name is Maya, and I'm with the Chesapeake Bay Foundation, and I'm here to talk to you today about nutrients. So maybe you've heard of nutrients, and what exactly are they? Well, they're basically chemical compounds that all living things need to grow. So you and me, we're living things. Plants and animals are also living things. So all these things need these nutrients to grow. So some common ones we're going to be talking about today are nitrates and phosphates. So maybe you've heard of these before. We're going to talk about some sources where they come from, and also how do they affect our water quality. So when we're talking about water quality, we're talking about the health of waterways. That could be your local stream, it could be the Chesapeake Bay, or it could be the ocean. What we're going to talk about is really how do these nutrients affect our waterways and what does it mean. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to take a deeper dive and see, well, where are these nutrients coming from? Where are some local sources? And we're going to have a really fun neighborhood nutrient hunt, and that's what we're gonna do to go see some local sources of nutrients in our neighborhood, just like this one. So I hope you come along. We'll have the rest of my team, and we're gonna find some nutrients in our neighborhood. Hey friends, so welcome to our neighborhood nutrient hunt. We're gonna go look around for different sources of nutrients in our local neighborhood. I'm right now in the backyard of in the woods. So I'm gonna check and see if I can find any different sources of nutrients. And of course I have my handy dandy magnifying glass to help me scope out some sources. So come along, let's go. Aha, looks like we found a clue. So right here is actually a system, and if you guessed it, it's not the storm drain system, that's a whole separate system here. We actually have the sewage system, and I do want to point out that it is next to a very local stream. And so what happens here is we have human waste in here, and that is a source of nutrient pollution. All the excess nutrients that we actually put out in our waste is contained in a sewage system. But what happens if that sewage system then overflows or the pipe busts? Well, then it gets into our local stream here, which happens to be in the watershed. So right here is the Little Patuxent River. It then flows into the Patuxent River and then into the bay. If we do get some sewage there, that's a source of nutrient pollution. So that is one source there. We found another clue. Right behind me is Route 95. That is one of the other sources of nutrient pollution. Well, how, you may ask? Well, as we have all the cars and trucks that go all across this road daily, thousands of trucks and cars, they can contribute to nutrient pollution by the chemical runoff that is coming out of these vehicles. And as you can see, it's on a big hill. So if it rains, that water then rushes off into our local stream down here. And that would then be a source of our nutrient pollution. Thank you guys for joining us on our neighborhood nutrient hunt. Now I challenge you to go out and take your handy dandy magnifying glass and see if you can find different sources of nutrients in your own neighborhood. And then we can talk about what are some solutions, what are some things we can do to make sure that we don't have a ton of nutrients washing into our local streams and rivers.
Hello all, welcome to our neighborhood nutrient hunt. And behind me we have a forest buffer. Follow me. In your typical forest buffer, you have soil that it holds in. It's very good with pollution. It helps prevent runoff for any nearby streams or waterways that could be nearby. Also, it's very good for, your natural animal habitat. This is a very good solution for any type of pollution for the water nearby. The next step is actually getting the trash up out of there.
Hey, we're out on our neighborhood scavenger hunt, seeing what we can find to reduce some of the runoff into the bay. I'm sitting here next to some grasses and clover, and actually this area is really, really special because it's been seeded with native wildflowers, and it's still early spring, but in about a month, the flowers are gonna start to come up, and we're gonna have taller and taller growth with all kinds of beautiful colors, and all of those pretty flowers are going to slow down the water and the nitrogen heading into the bay. They're gonna slow the runoff, and hopefully most of it will go into the ground here, filter into the ground rather than providing excess nutrients in the Chesapeake. So let's see if we can get a closer look. So here we can see how lush and thick all of this is already. All kinds of different things happening in here, but it'll be really, really, really exciting to see it get tall with all kinds of beautiful native species.
So let's talk about solutions. What are some things that we can do to make sure that we don't have a lot of excess nutrients washing down into our local waterways? So as you can see behind me, this is a great example of a solution. This is what we call a bioretention pond. I know, a mouthful, bioretention. Basically what it means is you're just using biological ways to slow down that water and kind of help control for all that natural, all that excess runoff and all that excess nutrients that's washing into local waterways. So what we have here is a little pond, and you'll see we have rocks. So that's a natural way there that kind of helps spread and slow the water down. And as that water, like we're talking about a big rainstorm here, as it's coming down into the pond, it then sits for a little bit and it actually feeds the trees and the plants that you see that are sitting right in this pond. So it kind of helps slow down that water, and then whatever excess water becomes drained from here will then be exited back into the local stream. Now, mind you, trees and plants are also a great filter. So this is also a nice filtration system. So whatever runoff was coming off of the roads or out of the storm drain pipes in the beginning have now been kind of filtered, and it's not as bad. We don't have as much nutrients, hopefully, going back into our waterways. So that's one way that we have a solution here with our nice bioretention. You can also call them rain gardens. Those are nice ways that we can help slow down that water and kind of spread and help soak it in so that we don't have a lot of excess nutrients going into our waterways there.